welcome. You're watching Markets at Money Control. Here we wrap up the day's trading action for you. I'm Rakshita Madan, and joining me is Santosh Nair, editor Money Control. Hi, Santosh.
Hi, Rakshita.
We saw quite a strong day today. The start was strong through most part of the day was actually we saw gains. But in the late trade, all the gains were wiped off. What actually went wrong?
Well, Rakshita, when the market is close to its record highs, traders tend to be a little jittery, because the all-time high acts as an immediate resistance level, and probably we would have seen that the Nifty failing to sustain above 10,137, which is its all-time high. In fact, at the start of trading this morning, most technical analysts thought that it would be an easy run for the bulls, but that was not to be the case. We saw heavy selling in oil marketing companies, bank stocks too started off on a firm note but couldn't sustain the gains. The trend in global markets was largely mixed. Asia closed mixed, and right now most European markets are also trading mixed at this point in time.
Right, oil marketing companies, like you said, took a beating today. There's news that there's lack of transparency in how the prices are being set. So the question here is, are we going to see some kind of regulation in the coming months?
The chatter in the market is that the government seems to have gotten into election mode already. Now, the government has been getting some bad press over the last few days with headlines screaming that diesel and petrol prices are at three-year highs, even though internationally crude prices have been declining. So today's news reports that the government may ask oil marketing companies to bear the cost if crude prices rise further. That could probably be a response to all the bad press that they've been getting. Well, the other option for the government would be to reduce excise duty, but that means taking a hit on its own revenues. So probably the government does not want to do that at this point. We saw some huge selling in stocks like IOC, BPCL and HPCL. All of them were down about 4 to 6%. BPCL gave up almost its entire gains it had made yesterday when it was among the prominent gainers on news of it having been conferred the Maharatna status. And the near-term outlook for the oil marketing sector in general appears to be a bit bleak if crude prices continue to rise this way.
Right. You mentioned about the mid-caps also. So they had a bad day today. Can that be some kind of trend to look forward to, or can it be considered a one-off day today?
Well, it's too early to call a trend because mid-caps have been rising steadily for the last many weeks now. Mid-cap indices have been making new highs. So one day clearly is very hard to call. Although investors would be tempted to take profits at the first sign of weakness, given that most of them, if they've been holding on to their positions, have made fairly good amount of money. And also, Rakshita, remember that mutual funds are flush with cash at this point in time. They need to deploy that money somewhere. So where do they do that? Already, frontline stocks are trading quite expensive at an average of about 24 times 1 year forward earnings. So clearly, mid caps will be the space where investors, where fund managers put their money. So I think purely on basis of in terms of liquidity, I think mid caps should do well in the short term.
Right. And top gainers and losers of the day?
So pharma stocks seem to be back in favor. Sun Pharma was the top gainer among Nifty stocks, gaining about 5%. Broking firm Credit Suisse has upgraded the stocks. That could have improved sentiment for Sun Pharma shares. Dr. Reddy gained about 2.4%. That was the other big gainer in the Nifty. But the star performer clearly was Reliance Industries. It hit a record high today and gained over 3%. But for the strength in Reliance Industries shares, probably you would have seen a steeper decline in benchmark indices today. Among the prominent losers, you had ITC, which was down by about 2%. Cipla was down by about 1.4%. Jubilant Foodworks was the biggest loser in the mid-cap space, and probably that would have had a rub-off effect to some extent on other mid-cap stocks as well. Now, a customer of Domino's Pizza posted a video online of bugs crawling out of a seasoning sachet that he got along with the Domino's pizza he had ordered, and that triggered a sell-off in the stock, which ended finally about 6% lower.
Right. All right, Santosh, thanks a lot for joining me. With that, it's a wrap on this edition of Markets at Money Control. For more news, views and updates, stay logged on to moneycontrol.com.